So we're going to do a quick walk around, show you how we set up the studio, and we'll start off with the lighting, which we didn't have much of a budget for. First up is these overhead lights, and they are just outdoor lights. They are app controlled. They're pretty rubbish really, but they do a good job in here. We had to make cardboard shuttering for them, and you'll notice that that one's a different height to that one. And this one's actually cut out on the back side, so it casts light down onto the board here. And they're all set to a 3200 colour. Different brightnesses, they're slightly brighter at the front than they are at the back, and the light from those sort of spools down on the back wall. Next thing we did was to give some purpose to the lighting. We put these tube lights up. So, nanolight tube lights, they last about 40 minutes. There's four in a kit. They charge up quick enough that we can get them back up again. Although, often we go, fuck, the lights stopped in the middle of the shoot. You'll also notice that in the background there was a blue light which extended under the car. That's some cheap newer lights. We've got one sat down here. And then we have another one in the middle of the floor with a piece of cardboard on it. It's switched on this plug. Now, a piece of cardboard stops the blue light from reflecting on the white on that drum. But in the shot, it just looks like the blue from that back corner is underneath the car. We've also got this light here. That's normally sat in the passenger seat in the car. That's what we use to illuminate the inside of the vehicle. On this side, against the wall, again, cheap newer lights. We've got one here with a piece of cardboard. That is set to illuminate the back wheel. And then we've got one over here, which is set to illuminate the front wheel. And it also helps with just doing a catch light whenever Tammy's at the front of the car and stuff. Although we actually roll this light in to do the main lighting for the face and the skin tones. That's also why this piece of cardboard is falling off all the time. And that's because every time I roll that over the roof of the car to put light all the way across the car, I hit that every single time. A final trick, a final light, is this one. That's two reasons. One is for a little bit of support because it's on such a length going up. But the other is also that that light and that bend caps the light off here and stops it going onto the back wall. And the back wall, we wanted to keep this very sort of cream colours behind the car whilst giving a good light on it. This is a coupon light stand. Most expensive light stand I've ever bought. It was about £350 and it is amazing. Had to improvise with my weight. Battery charger is sat here to hide the leg, because a lot of shots where we come around the front, you could see the leg, so we just dropped the battery charger there to hide it. Next, the props. We have the welder. The reason we have the welder sat here is actually for lighting. So when the camera's right at the front, looking this way, this light here becomes very visible. So we've got a piece of cardboard on a stand with a clamp. It just sits there to block the light, and then the welder blocks the cardboard. It doesn't fully block it, but it hides it. We also have this door shut so we don't get any spill. The welder has got chalk marks, so we know exactly where to put it when we need to move it. And the same with the trolley jack. In fact, all of these light stands up as well. If we look down here, you can see where they're marked, which is especially useful for this light because we knock it over about twice a day. It's survived a year. The other thing we had to do was, this building's got lots of skylights in it. If you look up here, so we've ended up having to block the skylights that are here, three on this side and one on that side. And we did that with these. So these are moving blankets. They were 25 quid for 10, I think, from Amazon. And plastic waste pipe tubing with push fit 90 degree bends. And then all we did was just cable tied the cloth onto it. They are then push fitted, they're just a good fit, and they push in. Because of that metal beam has a ridge on it, it pushes in and sits on the ridge at that top, and at that end we just squeeze it up and a single clamp holds it in place. This one goes over here and we stand it up against that, and what it does is it cuts the light out in this area of the lamp and it stops the light spilling all the way across here. Especially when the sun shines and things. I'll just take it away. And so you get the light over there that just shades out when you put that in. So that's what that one's for. The barrel. Why is the barrel there? Simple. We've got a shelf down here. Whenever we're filming at the chalkboard or anything, the clapperboard gets put down here so you can't see it. So I'm behind the camera, Tammy will go clap, puts the board down, and then we can film. So that's kind of the setup we've got around here. Let's move on to gear.